الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على النبي الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. Today's qiraat will begin in the middle of Surah Al-A'raf, in the story of Prophet Shu'ayb alayhi salam. And this surah will be completed and then we will go into Surah Al-Anfal. Now, Surah Al-A'raf, we mentioned yesterday, focuses on the stories of the prophets. Right? And this juz begins in the middle of that portion, in the middle of the story of Prophet Shu'ayb alayhi salam. And the bulk of the verses that we will recite in the first half of the Tarawih will focus on the story of the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. Now, this is a very important passage in the Quran, or a very important story in the Quran. You will find that the story of Prophet Musa alayhi salam is repeated in the Quran more times than any other story. This is the most repeated story in the entire Quran, because the lessons of the story of Prophet Musa alayhi salam, they are lessons for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his ummah, in that the stories of that ummah and this ummah are very similar. The Prophet Musa alayhi salam had to deal with a tyrant, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam had to deal with Abu Jahl, and right until today the ummah still has to deal with tyrants. And Prophet Musa alayhi salam had to deal with the second largest ummah in the history of this world. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has to deal with the largest ummah in the history of this world. And Prophet Musa alayhi salam, from his followers they were righteous, and from his followers they were sinners. And from the followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they are those who are righteous and they are those who are sinners. And so you will find a lot of parallels between the two stories. And that is why the story is repeated in the Quran more than any other story. Because the lessons from the life of Prophet Musa alayhi salam are timeless. Whatever era you are living in, you can see something in the life of Musa alayhi salam that is relevant to your life and you can apply it to your life. And so while these verses are being recited, let us reflect on the story of Musa alayhi salam and how these lessons can apply to us. Now, towards the end of tonight's recitation, we will get into Surah Al-Anfal. And this is the beginning of the jihad surahs. So tomorrow's qiraat is basically the juz of jihad, right? The 10 juz of the Quran, all the kuffars know that's the juz of jihad. It's Surah Al-Anfal and Surah Tawbah. So Surah Al-Anfal was revealed after the Battle of Badr, and Surah Tawbah after the expedition to Tabuk. And so both of these surahs focus on jihad fi sabilillah. So what is Surah Al-Anfal about? Surah Al-Anfal is a series of verses explain to us all the lessons that we can learn from the Battle of Badr. Because the Battle of Badr was one of those major turning points in the history of Islam. It was the first major battle between Islam and Kufr. It was the first major battle between the army of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the enemies of the Quraysh. And it was a decisive victory for the Muslims, even though they were outnumbered. It played a very fascinating role in how history changed from that point onward, because there's one point about this battle that a lot of people don't realize. You see, when you look at the leaders of the disbelievers of Makkah, there were two generations of leaders. The older generation, Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, right, Umayyah, all of these individuals died at Badr or around that time. Abu Lahab didn't go to Badr, but he died around that time. But all these other individuals, most of them died in Badr. The ones who survived, this is what's fascinating, the leaders of the enemies who survived Badr. So who are the leaders after Badr? Suhail ibn Amr, Abu Sufyan, Ikrimah, Safwan, Amr ibn al-As, Khalid ibn Walid. What do they all have in common? They all eventually become Sahaba. They all eventually become Sahaba. So this is a major turning point in history. Because from this point onwards, the Muslims are no longer fighting people who are going to fight them to the death. They are fighting people who are now more open to their message and who eventually end up accepting their message. And so that makes a major difference. With an earlier generation, it was a stubbornness from Abu Jahl and his associates. They were extremely stubborn that they knew. For Abu Jahl, for example, he knew that the Prophet Muhammad was a true messenger. And he knew that Islam was the truth. And he even saw angels. But still he didn't believe. That was their stubbornness. The next generation were more open-minded. You look at his own son Ikrimah. His own son Ikrimah narrates that when he was running away from Makkah, when the Prophet Muhammad conquered Makkah, and he was running away, and he got on a ship, and the waves began to rock the ship, And then the captain said, throw away your idols and ask Allah for help because only He can save us now. Ikrimah said, that's when I realized that this is the true prophet and what his message was a true message. Because this is what the Quran said as well. And so he went back to Makkah and he became a Muslim and he became one of the Sahaba and he died in jihad. Look at the difference between one generation and the next. So the Battle of Badr was a very important turning point in our history. And that's why an entire surah was revealed, laying out all of the lessons from this battle. And this is Surah Al-Anfal. From this surah, we learn many, many things. One of the most important lessons we learn from Surah Al-Anfal is that numbers are not insignificant in the sight of Allah. It is our iman and our taqwa that makes a difference. That sometimes we feel we are very few. And we wonder whether we'll ever be able to achieve victory in our own goals and in our own projects. But Allah will give victory to whomever He wills if they are sincere. And just as the Sahaba were victorious in Badr, if you have a project that you are working on for the sake of Allah, it doesn't matter how few people support it. If it is sincerely for the sake of Allah, Allah can put barakah in it, Allah can give you victory for that. So these are some of the lessons from Badr. And tomorrow, inshallah, we look at Surah Tawbah and some of the lessons from the expedition of Tabuk. Subhana Rabbil Izzati Amma Yasifun, wa salamun ala al-mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.